Thank you. Good afternoon and welcome to the United Center for the Northern Illinois Hockey League Tournament 16-19U Championship. This game features the North Shore Warhawks and Badger City. Now let's meet the teams. First, the North Shore Warhawks.
Go with number two.
Number two, Joey Burns.
Stand by with eight. Go with eight.
Number eight, Serena Gilani. Number 10, Abby Tumpak. Number 14, Vanessa Hazard. Number 16, Reese Doty. Number 18, Jenna Gilani. Number 22, June McMahon.
Let's go with 24.
Number 24, Sam Sitterly.
And 34 is next. Go.
Number 34, Mary Balsek.
Stand by with 42 and go with 42.
Number 42, Nina Griffiths. Number 44, Abby Huning. Number 49, Bryn Clare. Number 57, Paige Hines. Number 61, Claire Kennedy. Number 66, Kennedy Morsick. Number 72, Allison Hojack. Number 77, May Tannenberger. The head coach is Andy Doty. Assistant coaches Mary Hazard and Nina Pook. The manager is Amy Sitterly. And now for Badger City.
Go with number four.
Number four, Haley Shady. Number six, Lauren Rice. Number nine, Kiara Ballweg. Number 10, Peyton Sawyer. Number 11, Julia Purinton. Number 12, Kieran Merrill. Number 13, Riley Cowan. Number 14, Allie Fulton.
18 is next on the list. Let's go with 18.
Number 18, Avery Jarothanis. Number 19, Annie Milota. Number 20, Mara Knoth. Number 21, Evie Kellenhofer. Number 25, Maya Normington. Number 27, Avery Schwab.
31 is next, and let's go with 31.
Number 31, Jesse Damarese.
And now number 5, Scuta. Let's go with 5.
Number 5, Hannah Shady.
And here she is.
The head coach is Rachel Rice. Assistant coaches Brandon Baldwin and Mike Keegan. The manager is Julie Fulton. At this time, the Chicago Blackhawks invite you all to stand if you are able. Please remove your hats for our national anthem.
Welcome back into the United Center. This is game 3 of 6. This is the girls 16 and 19 U National Championship. It's the Badger City girls, the top seed, taking on the 2 seed, the North Shore Warhawks, alongside my partner, Eric Woolite, the man running the broadcast, Mike Napolitano. My name's Aaron Schellen, and Eric, we've seen 2 really fun games so far. 10U finishing an undefeated season. The Vernon Hills Ice Dogs, that 10U team. And then in overtime, the top seed Joliet Jaguars came from 1 goal down, scoring with 8 seconds left in period 3, winning it in overtime. They are the 12U champions now. The girls, 16U, 19U, are on center ice here looking for the Nye-Hill Blackhawks Tournament Championship.
I'm starting to think you're the you bring on the overtime wherever you go now, Aaron.
Yeah, that's 4 overtime games in my last 6 called games here for Nye-Hill, dating back to yesterday at Fifth Third Arena. So let's take a look at the bracket. Top seed Badger City got here with a 3-1 victory on the 10th over the Chicago Hawks, while the 2 seed Warhawks got past the GAA 19 Hawks by the score of 3-2. Badger City undefeated regular season, 11-0-1 on the year, and just absolutely ridiculous goals for and against. 52 goals for, only 9 goals allowed in 12 games for Badger City. The Warhawks 7-1-4 on the regular season. They finished in second place, outscoring their opponents by more than a 2-1 margin as well. These two teams played twice during the regular season. Back on December 16th, It was a 4-1 Badger City victory. And then the only blemish on this Badger City schedule came via the hands of the Warhawks, a 2-2 draw on January 22nd. So that one tie for Badger City this year came at the hands of the Warhawks. So we'll see if the Warhawks have a victory up their sleeve here this afternoon as we are into game 3 of 6 here at the United Center for the Nyhill Blackhawks Tournament. The Northern Illinois Hockey League is the largest youth hockey league in Illinois and one of the largest in the country. It is made up of over 50 travel hockey organizations. Almost all the clubs are from Illinois, with a few from Indiana, Iowa, Missouri, Michigan, and Wisconsin. This is the 54th season of play in the Northern Illinois Hockey League. The Nyhill member organizations field Tier 2 travel teams that compete in the Squirt, Pee Wee, Bantam, and Midget age groups defined by USA Hockey. The league also offers all-girls hockey divisions each season. Nyhill partners with the Chicago Blackhawks to hold this Nyhill Blackhawks tournament. For more information about Nyhill and its programs, please contact Bob After, the Nyhill president, or visit the website at nyhill.info. And we are about 1 minute away from puck drop, and two championships have been decided so far, Eric. We've got four more on the agenda, the 16U-19U game here right now, followed by the boys' Bantam 14U championship. Then we got a pair of college prep, the boys' 16U, followed by the 18U to finish things up for really what's been two full days of hockey for Mike and I. 7 games yesterday over at Fifth Third Arena, 6 more here today at the United Center. But I can't think of a better way to spend my weekend than watching hockey.
Yeah, I mean, this is the best of the best, right? The beauty of all this is that it continues to come down to the 1 and 2 seeds.
Yep.
And that's what we're seeing here as well in our 16-19U girls national game, as we did with the first two Premier Select games. So just keep queuing up the top two teams, and it makes its way chalk.
Yep, that's right. And, I mean, the great thing about that last game that we saw is that during the regular season between the Mission Girls 12U and the Joliet Jaguars, is Mission was 2-0-1 against Joliet during the regular season. Joliet came in as the 1 seed. Mission came in as the 2. And Joliet won. They won where it mattered, right? Mission took 2 out of 3 from Joliet during the regular season. But when it comes down to that winner-take-all, it was taken by the top seed Joliet Jaguars. So the Jaguars are champions. Vernon Hill Ice Dogs are champions. And here it'll be either Badger City or the North Shore Warhawks. We're going to play 14-minute periods here at the United Center. Down to our left, Badger City rocking what I guess you could call like kind of like the Seattle Kraken jerseys, right? With the white main color with that seafoam blue and darker blue with their numbers and names listed on the bottom, which is really unique and really interesting from a broadcaster perspective. When you think about it, a lot of these girls obviously have longer hair. Sometimes when that hair is not braided, it falls down in front of that name. We can't tell who you are.
Fans,
right off the
bat. If you're ready to watch some hockey, we need you to make some noise.
Hi, Jenna.
Jenna Rose getting the fans up and going here at the United Center.
Ooh, I like that.
And to our right, the North Shore Warhawks wearing their road greens, white numbers, white stripes on the back, sleeves, and legs. Starting goalie, still unsure for the Warhawks. I can tell you that Jessie Demarise will get the start, number 31 for Badger City. She's the only goalie on the roster. Makes it easy for me. A couple of goalies for the Warhawks. Reese Doty and Allison Hojak. We'll see who gets the start. As the Warhawks gather around their bench, Badger City appears to be ready to go here. They got looks like they're 5 skaters out there on the ice. And it looks like the starting goalie will be Reese Doty, number 16, for the North Shore Warhawks. So Doty in net for the Warhawks. Demarise in net for Badger City. And I thought we were ready to go, but apparently we're not. Warhawks taking another lap around the defensive zone. Waiting on the Zebras, it appears. And I think we're finally ready for some hockey.
Well, that would be good. Well, at least Badger City's ready.
Badger City's ready. They're lined up and ready to go. here we go. This will be Abby Tumpak on the draw for the Warhawks and Addy Malota for Badger City. It's won by the Warhawks into their own zone. Cleared up, chipped out to center ice by Bryn Clare. Badger City behind their own net, pushed up off the near boards. Played to Purinton, Julia Purinton out to space. Addy Malota will play it there. She gets across the blue line, gets knocked down, no call. Purinton now below the red line. Purinton on the backhand, back to the near dot. And the Warhawks will skate it out to center ice. Cutting across the ice is Kennedy Morzik. She'll gain the blue line, dump it in. Pass is given away, though, by Badger City. But they are able to dig it out to center ice. Cross-ice pass over to Evie Kellenhofer. She clears it in, but that'll be an icing. A minute gone by here in the first period. The North Shore Warhawks and the Badger City Girls playing for this 16U-19U National Championship. Draw to the left here of Demarise. It'll be taken by Jenna Gilani. It's one back, though, by Badger City. Nice outlet pass. Skating out with it's Haley Chady. Chady down the far side. Backhand feed. Backhand toss on the net. And that goes wide. Coming the other direction. Warhawks have it tipped away at center ice. Badger City will possess. Into the feet of Chady. Haley Chady out there. Hannah Chady. Here's a giveaway. A shot. And the save is made by Doty. So Haley and Hannah Chady, 4 and 5 for Badger City. Hannah came out on one of those little push walkers. She had a boot on one of her feet, and I don't know if you saw it during the national anthem, Eric, but it was all lit up. Had Christmas lights all over it.
I missed that part. Yeah. I saw that she was wheeling out.
Yeah. All decorated and lit up for Christmas here in in the middle of February. Draw to the right now of Reese Doty. It's won by Badger City, far boards taken by the Warhawks. That's Serena Galani behind the net. Galani tries to walk forward with it, pinned up against the boards, out to center ice, and Badger City will have to give chase. Chipped off the boards again. Top of the near dot. Puck's batted around, taken by Badger City. This is Evie Kellenhofer out to center ice. Dumped in deep by Riley Cowan behind the net. Collision there. Three green jerseys. That's Nina Griffiths. Pushed around the near side. Chipped up to the near point. Kept in over there by Badger City. Top of the near dot. The shot deflected wide off the stick of Kieran Merrill. Excuse me. Out to center ice. Chipped into the neutral zone. And that'll be whistled down for another offsides. Couple good opportunities for Badger City here in the early going, Eric. Warhawks still looking for that first real positive offensive shift. Cleared in by Badger City, but right onto the stick of Bryn Clare. Tries to work it out to center ice. She can't. Puck's given away. Slap shot from in between the dots goes wide of the near post. Warhawks now skate out to center ice with it. On the backhand, that's Abby Tumpak. She throws it forward on the backhand, taken there by the Warhawks behind the net. Centering feed. Nobody home. Badger City the other direction now. This is Avery Schwab. Schwab cuts between the dots, shoots it wide. Down in the near corner now, that's Purinton. Purinton pushing Tumpak up against the boards. Puck is stolen away. It's pinned up against that near post by Reese Doty, who will get a whistle.
Well, you can see Badger Cities are the early aggressors here, Aaron. They're getting most of the chances. Kind of a one and done for the Warhawks on the other end on that last rush, but it kind of feels like a little bit of a feeling out process, but these teams, you know, they've competed, so.
They've played each other twice this year, so they're familiar with each other, but, you know, we talked about this in the last game. Every single game, every mistake is amplified, so neither team wants to make that first mistake and give the other team an opportunity to play with the lead. So close to the vest, not all that surprising in the early going. This is Sam Sitterly. Stops and spins at the near half boards. It's dumped in deep. backhanded centering feed cleared into the corner. That's Burns into the slot and the shot in. And Demarese is forced to make the save. So we've seen a couple of times Warhawks turning Badger City turnovers into offense. And good shift there by the Warhawks. The backhand off the stick of Sam Sitterly.
Yeah, Warhawks trying to reclaim some momentum or get some momentum after Badger City getting the early go of it. So that was a good response by the team in green.
Kara Ballwig up along the far boards. Backhanded, nice indirect feed to Lauren Rice. Rice walking in all alone. Rice on the backhand, and she scores. Nice move by Lauren Rice, and Badger City takes a 1-0 lead.
Boy, that was a pretty move. You're not kidding, Aaron. Just kind of blew right in past the blue line, and then able to tuck that one in. 1-0 lead for Badger City.
Yeah, she had Reese Doty out of position once she got into the offensive zone as well, and that was an easy tap-in goal going around the Warhawks defense, just on the forehand to the backhand, way out of the net, Reese Doty. And once she beat Doty, that was an easy tuck-in goal for Lauren Rice. 1-0, Badger City with the lead. Coming down the near side with it. Shot, left pad save made by Demarese off the stick of Jenna Galani. Out to center ice, and here's another breakout attempt.
Badger
Riley
City
Cowan.
Goal scored by number 6, Lauren Rice. Assisted by number 13, Riley Cohen. Time of the goal, 3:45. Badger City goal scored by Rice, assisted by Cohen at 3:45.
Here's a slap shot from the near point that's deflected wide. You heard that. Cohen with the assist, Rice with the goal, 1-0 Badger City. Back to the point. And I talked about this in the pregame. Badger City's only given up 9 goals in 12 games, so quick math tells you that that's less than a goal a game. Out to center ice.
I was still told there'd be no math.
No math.
Broadcasting.
You're right. Yeah, you know, Mike and I were talking about that yesterday. They usually give you the numbers.
Right.
They don't ask you to do the math.
Right.
Cross ice feed here onto the stick of Schwab. Schwab back to the near point where Merrill will play it. She'll turn and fire it in. Behind the net. Warhawks possess. It's sticked away, though, by Badger City nicely in the corner. That's Haley Chady. Chady behind the net on her forehand. Centering feed, the one-time attempt, healed by Kellenhofer. But here's an opportunity for Ballwig that's swept aside by Doty. Down low, Badger City maintains possession. Worked out to the blue line. Shot flipped up into the air, and the Warhawks will try to come the other way with it. Gaining the blue line is Huning. Abby Huning pushes it around to the far side. Through the paint coming out the other side. Back to the point, out to center ice, and battling for the puck. Coming out with it is Bryn Clare. Throws it over to the opposite corner. Behind the net, Warhawks have it. This is Hunig, up into center ice, dropped down smartly by Morzik. Morzik takes the shot, and it's into the glove of Jesse Demarese.
You and I, we did the girls' all-star games back at Catlin in West Dundee.
Yep.
And for the 16-19 U game, it was pretty much littered with Badger City and Warhawks.
Yeah.
Remember when they were introducing all the all-stars?
Yeah, I want to say that each team had 7 players. Number sticks out in my head. And it's not a surprise. Top 2 teams in the league tend to have the best players, right? So that's why we are where we are. And we get a quick icing called here on Badger City. So another draw back in their defensive zone with 7:43 left to go in period 1. Lauren Rice picking up the first goal. Riley Cohen with the assist. Drawn out of the left here of Jesse Demarese. That is Rice on the draw, and she wins it clean. Back to Maranoth. Stolen away, though, and fortunate bounce for Badger City as it scoots away from a Warhawk skater, taken here by Peyton Sawyer. Sawyer on her backhand tries to shovel it forward, gets it back in between the dots, stick checked away. In the high slot area, Schwab with the shot. That's steered into the near corner. Up the near half boards with it now is Sitterly. Sitterly out to center ice. She'll gain the red line, fire it in, but not very deep. Collected there by Kellenhofer, taken right back, and now it's dumped in deep by the North Shore Warhawks. Kellenhofer tries to push it aside. She can't. There's a collision behind the net. Puck is sitting right by that near post, and Demarise gets the mitt on it to cover up.
What's your over-under on penalties in this girls' 16-19U game?
I hope there aren't many. I want to see just a nice, clean, back-and-forth, up-and-down game without a lot of whistles.
What if Mad Dog Licadini was in this game?
Mad Dog, a member of the Mission at 12U team, is she'll commit a penalty here and there, but as I said during that game, I love that young woman's style of play. She is 100% all-go the entire time she's out on the ice, so... You take the good with the bad sometimes with players like that, is they just bring so much value to the team.
Yeah. And she got her requisite penalty in that game.
She did. She had a breakaway that would have given her team a two-goal lead, but was stoned kind of in the final minutes, and team ended up losing in overtime. But that's a very good team. There's a shot over the net by Addie Malota off the back of the apron over into the far corner with it. It's pushed around to the near side, and the Warhawks possess. Out to center ice, nice outlet pass. Finds Hunig, Abby Hunig down the near side. That's steered away by the left pad of Demarise. Into the corner. Pushed up along the far half board, stick lift. Badger City able to skate it out to center ice smartly, though. This is Allie Fulton. Fulton near dot. Tries to center it as she gets down deep, loses the puck. And the Warhawks are able to get it up to center ice and out. Taken right back, though, by Ballwig. Kiara Ballwig stopping at the blue line. She'll push it in. That takes a funny bounce off the end boards. Has to be swept away by Doty. Long outlet pass into the Badger City zone, where Kieran Merrill plays it up ahead. Into the feet of Riley Cohen. Knocked away from her. Battle right in front of us, two to a side, right in front of the penalty boxes. Over to the far side of the ice, where Abby Tumpak will play it in. Dump and chase here for the Warhawks. Taken there by Burns. Burns centering feed, but nobody home, and Badger City now out to center ice with it. Over to space was Merrill, but there were no white jerseys over on that side, so the Warhawks will play it. Chipped up into the air, collision right at the blue line. Warhawk skater goes down, and this is Lauren Rice off of her stick. Rice able to work through the defense, having her stick held. Some thought we might see that first penalty there, but nothing doing.
Play on, I guess.
Play on, and that's what Julia Purinton tries to do. Plays it back to the point, and Kellenhofer will dump it in deep. Another collision behind the net. Here's a giveaway. Cross ice, the one-time attempt healed by Avery Schwab. She had nothing but open net. She didn't need to one-time, and I don't think, Eric. She'll get another opportunity here. Nice left pad save made by Doty. And a potential breakaway if she can hurry for the Warhawks. Stopping there is Burns. Burns has to wait for her line mates to tag up. But that was a great opportunity for Badger City, Eric. I don't think Schwab needed to one time. I think she could have settled that puck down, shot it, and still had an open net.
Yeah, you get a little anxious, though, when you see that open net, right?
Here's a shot from the near point by Balsik, and the left arm save made by Demarise, and Jesse will cover up. Yeah, I think you're right. You know, I don't know if it's nerves. I don't know if it's jumpiness, but... You get that play really low down, and you're just like, I want to get the shot off, but we're seeing the replay here, and Reese Doty was nowhere near that far post, and just not able to be tucked in by Avery Schwab. Cleared into the offensive zone for the Warhawks, skated out into center ice, and the Warhawks come the other direction with it now. Nice move there by Morzik. Morzik in. Morzik, she whiffs on the shot a little bit, but that's a prime scoring opportunity right in between the dots. Skater goes down, no call. Taken there by Badger City. Back to the point. Warhawks walk in, blockered away by Demarise. This is Morzik again. She has her pocket picked. Badger City out to center ice now. Banged into right at the blue line is Marinath, and Nath went in ahead of the play. So it'll be an offside with 2 minutes, 38 seconds left to go in period one. 1-0. Badger City with the lead.
Yeah, a lot of perimeter action for the Warhawks, although they did get a couple opportunities in on DiMarassi, but they need a few more, right?
Yeah, they've had a couple of in-close opportunities, but DiMarassi's done a nice job kind of holding that net here in the early going. Obviously a very good goaltender, only nine goals in those 12 games.
Right.
So off the back of the net. It's played here by Merrill. Badger City trying to work it out. They do work it out now to center ice. That's Rice. Rice tapping it forward to Sawyer. Gives it right back to Rice. Rice the goal scorer for Badger City. Here's Schwab now coming with a head of steam, has it on the backhand, switches to the forehand. The centering feed hopped up in the air. It's sitting in the paint that's underneath Reese Doty, and she gets a whistle. There's Julia Purinton, number 11, bearing down on that near side, trying to look for a rebound. That aerial pass just pinballing around. It went off the left arm of Purinton and ended up right in the crease. Drawn out of the left of Doty. And that stays right along the blue line, kept in by Schwab. Outlet pass misses everybody, and that should go the length of the ice for an icing. So we're about 90 seconds left in the first period, 1-0. Badger City with the lead. Only goal, Lauren Rice. It's a pretty move by Lauren. She takes the puck and sent it through center ice, makes a move to the inside on the Warhawks defender, then goes forehand, backhand, tucks it in the far post. Give Badger City that 1-0 lead. They made it hold up so far. Warhawks behind the net. That's McMahon. June McMahon pushes it around the near side. Backhanded up, but Badger City aggressive on the forecheck. Puck right at the blue line. Backhanded over to the far side of the ice. It's Jero Thanis who will dump it in. It's almost a steal and a break-in for Badger City, but Ballwig has to play it in her own zone.
1 minute remaining in the period. 1 minute.
Thank you. 1 minute left to go in the period. Puck is cleared in here by Badger City. Again, that aggressive forecheck by Badger City in the offensive zone is able to force a turnover. Puck is stolen there by Cohen. Puck bounces around in between the circles and out to center ice come the Warhawks. This is Morzik again. She goes down, four white jerseys around her. Tipped into the corner by Nath. Not up, the puck bounces past the far post. Backhanded centering feed and pushed over to the far boards by Badger City. Slung around the behind the net, and Badger City now out to center ice. Collision there, and could have been a potential call on Kieran Merrill, but nothing doing. Down to 7 seconds, out to center ice, and that will likely do it here for period number one, and it will. It ends with Badger City up 1-0.
Yeah, good first period there for Badger City. And the Warhawks looking for a solution in period two.
The Chicago Blackhawks are proud to sponsor the Northern Illinois Hockey League. Hawks fans, be sure to catch these upcoming games. Monday, February 19th, the Blackhawks travel to Carolina to take on the Hurricanes, 6 p.m. Central Time, NBC Sports Chicago. Wednesday, the 21st, the Flyers come a-calling to the right here, actually, 6:30 p.m. Yeah, games on TNT and Max. And then Friday, February 23rd, the Blackhawks will host the Winnipeg Jets. That's at 7:30 on NBC Sports Chicago. Don't miss the Chicago Blackhawks in action. Blackhawks want to let you know that they are excited to host their 2024 summer camps at four locations throughout Chicagoland for kids ages 6 through 13. Additionally, they are proud to present their all-girls camps, Big Stride, designed for girls ages 12 to 18. Included in the five-day camp, players will participate in two on-ice practices and 2 hours of off-ice activities each day. Full equipment and basic comprehension of skating is required. For more information and to register, please visit nhl.com/Blackhawks/amateur/hockey camps. So one period in the books here, Eric, and going pretty much, I think, as we would expect, right? Badger City undefeated in the regular season, only 9 goals allowed on the year, scored 52.
Yeah.
They're up 1 through 14.
Yeah, I mean, they're another program that just kind of steamrolled through the regular season, right?
Yep.
And you're seeing why that's the case here today.
The only team to put a dent in the armor of this Badger City girls team this year are these North Shore Warhawks. But right out of the chute, a 2-on-1. Here's a shot off the inside of the outside of the near post. And the Warhawks dig it out to center ice. Indirect pass, but I think that's going to be too far ahead for an icing. Yeah, the only team to put a dent in this Badger City team are these Warhawks, a 2-2 tie back in January. 11-0-1 on the season are these Badger City girls. The Warhawks, not bad themselves, 7-1-4, so they've only been beaten once this season, and it was by these Badger City girls. Puck fired in deep. He played down there by Vanessa Hazard along the far half boards. Flipped out to center ice. Again, that long indirect pass. They're looking for Joy Burns, not able to connect. Badger City the other way now. Shot in, whistled wide of the near post. That was Purinton. Julia got all of that wrist shot. Now it comes out to center ice. Potential 2-on-1. Here comes Burns. Burns the cross-ice pass. Finds Sitterly. Sitterly drops it for Tumpak. They're not able to connect. Those are the opportunities you need to convert on if you're the Warhawks here. You get those odd skater rushes. That's backhanded towards the net and covered up by Demarise at that far post. Yeah, Eric, if you're the Warhawks, you get a 2-on-1, 3-on-1 break. You need to be able to put that thing away.
Yeah, I mean, the pass to the far side, a little bit behind, and then they were trying to recover after that. Third skater was in, but by that time they were so far pushed to the perimeter, they couldn't do anything with it.
When you're playing a team that's 11-0-1 and has given up 9 goals in 12 games, you need to take advantage of every opportunity that's presented, because if you don't, things like that happen off the post.
Wow.
And out. I thought that was number 2 right there, but 2-on-1 the other direction. Just rings iron. Coming down through center ice with it here is Morzik. She misplays it, and it's scaled the length of the ice for an icing. So almost. And kind of double trouble there for the Warhawks, right? They have a 3-on-1 the other way that goes for nothing, and then Badger City comes down the other direction and rings it off the post, trying to get the name on that jersey. I think that's Kellenhoff, number 21, just rings it off the near post. She was that close, giving her team a 2-goal lead. Puck in the slot, sticked aside by Demarise. Down in the corner now, two skaters to a side, digging at it. Third white jersey gets involved, but here's a shot by Morzik, and the glove save made by Jesse Demarise. I've been impressed by number 66 in green so far, Eric. Kennedy Morzik, she's listed as a defenseman, but she's really pushing the offense here for the Warhawks.
Yeah, I mean, she's been very noticeable here in the early going. We're only a couple minutes into period 2. So I expect for her to play more of the same, right?
Yeah, we forget what period we're in, given we're on game 3 and game 2 went to overtime. Technically, it's period 9 for us.
Sure.
Out to center ice. Here comes Badger City across the blue line. Nice little backhand feed, hops up in the air. Nice drop pass. Here's a shot that goes wide. That was Giro Thanos shooting it wide of the far post.
Thanos?
Giro Thanos,
oh,
yes.
Okay.
Played there at the far half boards, cross ice pass. Looking for Addie Malota, not able to connect. Schwab has it at the near point, goes D to D. A hard slap shot wide by Kira Ballwig. Schwab tries to stick handle, can't. She falls down. Warhawks, three skaters. Badger City, two. In this case, two wins out over three. Allows Badger City to continue to play the puck in the offensive zone. Tipped forward and cleared out to center ice by the Warhawks. This will be Ballwig to play it. It's not going to be icing. She held up as long as she possibly could to try to draw that icing call, but nothing doing, and the puck comes the other way. No icing at that end either. This is tipped ahead by Serena Galani. She loses it. Haley Chady tips it wide of the near post. Back to the point. Here's Nath, fires the wrist shot. She's able to knock it down and keep the Warhawks from breaking out, but they may have an opportunity anyway. Coming in is Sitterly. Sitterly takes the shot. It goes wide of the far post, but she gets tripped up, and we're going to have our first penalty call of the game. It'll be a trip on Badger City for knocking down
sometimes
Sam Sitterly.
Yeah, sometimes there's good penalties, Aaron, and that's probably one right there. That was a clear scoring opportunity for the Warhawks.
And knocking her down will be Kieran Merrill will go to the box for the trip, but you're right. I mean, that trip forced that shot from Sitterly to go well wide of that far post, and with how good you've been playing defensively, you almost feel better about maybe getting set up defensively and playing shorthanded.
The Badger City penalty to number 12, Kieran Merrill. 2 minutes for tripping at 3:43. Badger City penalty to Merrill. 2 minutes for tripping at 3:43, resulting in a North Shore power play.
So there you have it. And here's a breakaway opportunity the other direction. Here comes Rice. Lauren Rice in all alone. Rice on the forehand, the backhand, and she gets it to go five hole on Reese Doty. And Eric, that's the same exact move she used on goal one. This time she pushes it five hole and gives her team a 2-0 lead.
Yeah, once she broke out down that far side, Aaron, you knew there was a likelihood she was going to tuck that in the net, and that's exactly what she did there. A shorty and a 2-0 lead for Badger City.
Yeah, and really, like I said, the same move. She added on her forehand. She went five hole, and almost knocking that one out was Reese Doty. Reese was able to get that right pad on it, but it bounced off the pad and into the back of the net. So there's that shorthanded goal, 2-0. Badger City with the lead. And they're right back on the attack, even though they're shorthanded. Warhawks will take it here. Pushed up to center ice. That's
Badger City, shorthanded goal, her second of the game, scored by number 6, Lauren Rice. Assisted by number 13, Riley Cohen. Time of the goal, 4:10. Badger City, shorthanded goal, second of the game by Rice, assisted by Cohen at 4:10.
Well, we give out 3 stars at the ends of each one of these games, and so far I think stars 1 and 2 are Rice and Cohen. Rice with 2 goals, Cohen with a couple of apples, and the shutout so far for Demarese. Puck into the high slot, taken there by Haley Chady. She flips it into the bench. So we'll have a whistle and a defensive zone draw, I believe. Yep. 9 minutes.
Coming back in, right.
9 minutes left to go in the middle frame. Draw to the right here of Jesse Demarese. Back to the point. D to D passing. Shot towards the point. Nice tip there by Tumpak, and the save is made by Demarese. Here's another shot from the point, and Demarese makes another save. Starting to see why this Badger City girls team has only given up 9 goals in 12 games, Eric. They have a brick wall and net.
Brick wall and net they do. It is good to see the Warhawks, though, respond after that second goal.
Yeah, and that's how you're going to do it. Shots from the point. Whoa, look at that glove save on the backhand. My, Sam Sitterly, the hard backhand, and Demarese makes it look easy. If you're the Warhawks, though, I mean, those last 3 shots, 2 of them had traffic in front, and that's generally how you're going to win those types of battles, is hit those shots in from the point, through traffic, hit bodies, go into the net.
Yeah, but you're right about Demarese. She's showing you why she's one of the linchpins for that Badger City squad.
Warhawks, 6 seconds left on the power play. Puck knocked away and backhanded in. That should do it. Julia Purinton kills the rest of the power play with that clear in out to center ice. Taken here by the Warhawks up through center ice, taking it wide. Here's a shot, left pad save off the stick of Tannenberger. Sitterly into the slot area behind the net. Burns not able to play the puck cleanly, and it'll trickle out towards the blue line. That does come out to the neutral zone, and that will be an offsides. Been a pretty clean game. We've only had the one penalty so far, Eric. Some fun up and down action. You know, not a lot of whistles in this one.
Yeah.
So it's been an enjoyable game to just kind of follow back and forth so far.
Yeah, it is a good pace.
Warhawks have it. It's cleared in. Badger City calmly out to center ice. Put to space. This is Maya Normington. She drops the puck. It's cleared behind the net where Fulton will play it. Fulton with the backhand. The shot over the top of the net. Normington, that's a prime scoring area. And Maya just a little too much underneath it. She used the pitching wedge when she should have used that 3-iron. Puck sitting in.
It doesn't matter which club I use, Aaron.
Yeah, it's going to go to the right.
Exactly.
Into the defensive zone. First attempt missed. Second attempt out to center ice. Here comes Balsik. Mary playing it ahead now to Paige Hines. Hines has her stick knocked out of her hands. It comes out to center ice. Back to the blue line. Warhawks try to work it in. They can't. Badger City content to just backhand it in to the Warhawk zone, and that'll be an icing. So we got three more after this. This is almost the midway point of our day here at the United Center. Game 3 of 6. The 10U, the 12U championships have been determined. Both top seeds won in those divisions. Vernon Hills Ice Dogs and Joliet Jaguars, respectively. We've got the finish of the 16-19U game here, and then we've got 14, 16, and 18. And here's a 2-on-1 breakout. Nice pass up ahead, and there's a pretty right pad save made by Doty.
Nice job by Doty there. Can't afford to fall behind 3-0 to Badger City, so.
Nope, and here's another 2-on-1. And beautiful stick work there by Morzik to knock that away. I talked about how she's listed as a defenseman, showing those D-chops right there. Badger City right back the other way, though. There's a shot that goes wide. Comes out the near side, and skating out with it is McMahon. She's knocked down from behind, no call.
Starting to see a lot of that speed difference between Badger City and the Warhawks right now.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, we've looked up, and they've had three two-on-ones in the last about 30 seconds of gameplay. Morzik across the blue line. She winds up, takes the shot, steered into the far corner by Jesse DeMarise. Badger City now out to center ice with some speed across the blue line. That's Malota. Malota in on the backhand, and there's a nice save by Doty. You talked about that speed. Speed is what created that opportunity. Back to the point. That's Nath, has it knocked away, and coming forward with it is Burns. She has no stick, so I'm not sure what she's going to do here.
Try to pass.
That was actually really fancy. She tried to step on the puck to slow it down and then do a little drop pass with her skate. I don't think I've ever seen that.
I've never seen a stickless breakaway.
No, neither have I, but she almost turned into something. She didn't have a lot of play, but she did a nice job dropping that for the skater coming up from behind, but good defense by Badger City to knock it away.
We got a good reel we can post.
Yeah. This puck is cleared out by the Warhawks. That'll come all the way down on DeMarise. She'll have to play it. Pushes it over to the far side where Kellenhofer throws it up through center ice. And that's a hazard back the other direction. This is Mary Balsik now dumping it in. Kellenhofer plays it again, pushes it around the near side. Fulton. Allie Fulton misses her intended target, and that'll be another icing here on Badger City with 4.5 left to go in the second period. Still 2-0. Badger City girls, the top seed, the undefeated Badger City girls looking to finish an undefeated season. I hesitate to call it perfect because they do have a tie,
yeah.
But I'm sure they would settle for undefeated season if you asked them.
Yeah. Oh, at this stage, yes.
Yes. Do you care?
Breaking news.
Do you care if you had a tie this year?
No.
The answer to that is no.
No.
Yes, I do not. Battle right on the blue on the red lines, taken there by the Warhawks. It's cleared in. Played behind the net. Jirothanis up to the near point. That shot is knocked down by a shin pad. Deflected up into the air. That'll all the way down into the North Shore defensive zone. No icing. This was deflected by a North Shore skater. Played up and out. Hines will give chase with Marin Nath. Nath will be the first one on it. Two green skaters on that forecheck. And that's knocked in from the neutral zone by Vanessa Hazard. That'll be an offsides.
I missed it.
Three minutes, 39 seconds left in the second period. Badger City wins the faceoff going forward, but it's taken there by Sitterly now. Sam turns and dumps it in. Here's Burns behind the net with some speed. Burns, the tour of the attacking zone, throws it towards the high slot area. Badger City chips it out to center ice. Pushed back, played by Kennedy. Kennedy up to the point, kept in by Badger City, and the Warhawks will take it right back, play it to space. That indirect pass, they've been trying that all day with Burns. They connect here. Burns on the wraparound shot, score!
Wow.
Abby Tumpak takes the feed from Joy Burns, and that lead is cut in half, 2-1.
Well, you're not kidding, Aaron. They've been working on that. That time it pays off. What a pretty play. They needed that goal big time.
Yeah, Joey Burns behind the net, found Tumpak streaming down the near side, and Abby didn't take any chances. She put that right up under the crossbar, Eric. Nothing that Jesse DeMarise could do about that one, and it's 2-1. And if you're the Warhawks, you got to feel really, really good about things right now. You're there within a goal of this Badger City team. They've had opportunities. They've been stonewalled by DeMarise. Every opportunity except for
North Shore goal scored by number 10, Abby Tumpak.
Yeah, we've talked about
before. Assisted by number 2, Joy Burns. Time of the goal, 10:57. North Shore goal scored by Tumpak. Assisted by Burns at 10:57.
Sorry, Johnny.
Finish your thought.
We always talk about late period goals and how they can add to a momentum. So here's your situation. You score that right around the three-minute mark. And if you can keep Badger City off the board here, don't let them get a quick response to go back up by two. You can carry that into the third period. Doesn't guarantee anything, but puts you in a much better spot.
Yep, late period goals are always good for plus momentum for the team that scored it. And in this case, it's the North Shore Warhawks. Out to the far side, here's Rice. She's got two. Behind the net. Warhawks try to dig it out. They can't. Puck bounces up into the air. Pushed around behind the net. Players bang into each other there. That's Sawyer and Claire. Claire up off the boards and kept in right at the point by Rice nicely. And it does eventually wiggle its way out to the neutral zone and back in. Four and offsides with exactly 2 minutes left to go in the second period.
Well, good pace you talked about. We've had a lot more whistles here in this second period.
I'm a firm believer in the announcer's jinx not being a thing.
Yeah.
But stuff like that happens, and it really makes you question it.
I know I do.
Badger City back in their own zone. D to D there, swung around to Merrill. Merrill not able to play it out. Puck bounces by the near circle. Stolen there. That's Morzik. Morzik on the backhand and on there on the back door for the tip attempt. Not able to connect, and now out the other side comes Badger City. That puck is deflected. We got a foot race here. Badger City will win it. Cross ice pass looking for Schwab. The pass is behind her. Now in the near corner, stolen by Melota. Abby Melota, high slot area, drop pass back to the point. The shot deflects, and I think that broke through the pads of Reese Doty, but it came out to the right rather than behind her.
Here's 1 minute remaining in the period. 1 minute.
Gracias. And you're talking about not wanting to give up that late period goal. Badger City putting some pressure on here, Eric, in the final, the waning moments of this period as the Warhawks are able to work it out to center ice finally. And again, it's number 66, Kennedy Morzik, who's kind of at the forefront of that attack for the Warhawks. Morzik dumps it in here. We're down to 30 seconds.
There's a very energetic fan down there.
Yeah, there's one, right?
Yeah.
Here's a backhand through by Tumpak is swept aside by the right pad and stick of Demarise into center ice, down to 17 seconds. The hard slap shot up over the net. Pushed behind the net. Joy Burns set up the first goal. Has it on her stick here. We're down to 8 seconds. Drops it there for Tumpak. The shot, excuse me, that's 24, that's Sitterly, backhanded towards the post, the shot in, and the save is made as the horn sounds. So good second period there, one goal for each team. The Warhawks will go to the third down by one. The regular season obviously is complete, and this is Nye-Hill Blackhawks tournament time. Keep your eye on the Nye-Hill.info and the Nye-Hill website. Nye-Hill.info website, the Nye-Hill Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages for news about upcoming broadcasts of Nye-Hill games. We're here for the rest of the day. Once this one is over, 3-ish, we're already a little bit behind because game two went to overtime. 3-ish is the Bantam Premier Select Championship. 5-ish is the College Junior Prep 16U Championship. And then 7-ish is the College Junior Prep 18U Championship. Stay tuned in right here on the Stream Sports Midwest YouTube channel.
I got to give a shout out to Nye-Hill and the Blackhawks for just putting on these championship games.
Yeah.
It's just like going to a Blackhawks game. It's the whole production, everything you're getting, the sound, the video,
it's a Blackhawks game without, you know, 18,000 people in here. It truly is. It's A-plus production, and you know, you got all the regulars here from the United Center doing their regular jobs, right? Whether it's PA or you know, the in-between stuff with Jenna and John. It's been an A-plus production, and it's been fun so far. We've seen we've seen three good games, and the Warhawks looking to be that first two seed to finally break through here. Is we've had two games finish with the one seed coming out victorious. So we'll see how period three goes here. Badger City with a 2-1 lead, two goals by Lauren Rice. And on the other side, it was Abby Tumpak from Joy Burns in that second period. And that was a huge goal, right? I mean, it's cliche to talk about that two-goal lead, but, you know, when you're down 2-0 in a championship game, going down 3-0 is a huge hole, especially it's a team that's given up 9 goals all season.
Right. And then so, you factor that in, you change, and you only have one more period to try and overcome that.
Right. But now we go to the third. They're only down one. Badger City, and there's that fan. You might be able to hear her.
Yeah.
Here's Rice with the puck on her stick. She'll clear it in deep. Played deep is Tannenberger. Hey, you know, I love the enthusiasm. Yeah. You know, I have no problem. You scream all you want. Yell, scream, cheer for your kids. That's why we're all here. Out to center ice, Badger City to space along the near boards. Chopped in by Peyton Sawyer, played by Tumpak. Abby turns around. She gets forechecked. I don't think she saw Rice there on her back. Rice steals the puck. Tumpak takes it right back, though. Along the near boards. Sitterly out to center ice. That's Burns with some speed, and that's good stick work right there by number 20, Marin Nath, and we're going to have a penalty called on Badger City. So the Warhawks with a chance to get this thing square on the power play.
Yeah, big hit in the corner there. And another penalty coming our way.
That'll be Nath. Marin Nath had made that really nice play initially to break up the play, knocked the puck away from Burns, but then Burns and Nath went into the corner, and Mara knocked her down and got whistled for it. Draw to the right here of Demarese. Walking forward with it, though, is Addy Melota. Melota with some space along the far side.
The Badger City penalty comes from 20. We're on and off. 2 minutes for roughing at 58 seconds.
Looks like Gene
Badger
got
City
a union
penalty
call
number 20. Knopf. 2 minutes for roughing at 58 seconds.
Yeah, we don't get those.
Yeah, no, we don't.
We don't get those.
Yes.
High slot area. Backhand is knocked down. Turn. Fires. Doesn't make it in on Demarese in the far corner with it.
Did you see Demarese's little poke there after that shot attempt?
Goalies do what they do, man.
Yeah.
Shot from the near point wide of the, or far point rather, wide of the far post. Worked around the near side now for the Warhawks. Back to the point. Morzik over to the far side with it. Top of the far circle. Morzik will play it low. Pushed around. It's McMahon. McMahon back to the point. Claire has it knocked away, and it's kept in and then batted away by Haley Chady. Chady's in all alone. Haley on the forehand. The backhand doesn't get all of it. Pushes the second attempt towards that post, and it's swept away by Doty. Just sort of rolled off the stick of Haley a little bit as she made her way in, made that last move. Indirect self-pass here, tapped forward nicely by Griffiths. Mia Griffiths in on the backhand, and what a glove save by Jessie Demarese to keep this thing 2-1.
I love how she vacates the net immediately after. It's like, yeah, no big deal.
Yeah,
that was a big deal.
That was a huge deal. Is a couple of nice, you know, and Eric, that pass, that self-pass from Mia Griffith got caught up in the snow right in front of the Badger City girls bench, and that gave Griffith the time she needed to catch up with the puck and be able to take that in. Here's an opportunity, bounces up and in, and we're all square at two. That's Abby Tumpak again, and we got a brand new hockey game.
Wow. Well, they continued the momentum, though. They continued pushing, and then getting that off the draw, that's huge.
Yep, those deflected shot from the point. Abby Tumpak has her second goal of the game. Tumpak right in front, and that hit the stick, Eric, of the defenseman, Kieran Merrill, and went right up over the left shoulder of Jessie Demarese, but Tumpak will get credit for it. So you, when you do good things, you make the right decisions, good things happen. Good things are happening for the Warhawks here over the last period or so. Here's Tumpak again looking for the natural Hattie. It's knocked away out to center ice. So 2-2, 11:15 left to go. We've already had one overtime game, and here's a 2-on-1 breakout for the Warhawks.
Number 10, Abby Tumpak.
Tumpak and Sitterly.
This is number 2, Joey Burns, and number 77, May Tannenberger at 2:28.
Couple of backhands and a couple of just gorgeous right pad saves by Demarese. Wow, she is keeping Badger City in the lead here. There's a shot in. It's knocked down by Warhawks.
Goal scored by Tumpak, assisted by Burns and Tannenberger at 2:28.
Burns and Tannenberger on the assist. That's two goals for Tumpak. Here is Burns. Burns has it with space, takes the shot, doesn't make it in. The backhand goes wide behind the net. Warhawks have it here. Pinned behind the net is Sam Sitterly. But the Warhawks, all the momentum right now, the green and white, for these North Shore Warhawks. Played a little bit deeper by Paige Hines. She loses it. It comes out to center ice, and the Warhawks will have to go back and chase. And I, you know, I certainly don't want to undersell what the Warhawks did this year. You know, we talk about Badger City being 11-0-1. The Warhawks lost one game as well. In 12 games, the Warhawks lost once.
Yeah.
And it was to this Badger City team. So this is a very, very good North Shore Warhawks team. So I don't want to short sell them. But what they're doing here over the last 12 minutes or so of play, I mean, they've really taken this game away from Badger City here since about the midway point of the second period.
Yeah, and I wouldn't say Jessie Demarese is under siege by any stretch of the imagination, but she is seeing a lot more pucks than she was in that first period.
Well, and every shot that the Warhawks have had here over the last handful of minutes has been a grade-A opportunity. She hasn't made any. She's made them look easy because she's obviously a really talented goalkeeper,
right,
but they have not been easy saves. This is Nath behind her net now. Hardup off the boards, and that'll be an icing. So 9:03 now left to go in the third period. 2-2. Draw to the left now of Demarese. That'll be Nina Griffiths taking it for the Warhawks. Griffiths almost tied the game right before Tumpak did. Draws one, though, by Badger City. Pushed around the near side. Hard backhand pass out by Purinton. Finds Addie Malota. Malota in, skates through a couple of green jerseys, loses the puck, now in the corner with it. Drops it for Purinton. Purinton back to the point, but it deflects up into the air. Pushed back in, back to the point, and that guy just died in the snow. And you can, they're just pushing piles of snow around right in front of the Warhawks bench.
We still got 8:35 to go here in this game, so that snow is going to continue to be a factor throughout.
Yep, and if we stay 2-2, they aren't going to clean the ice in between periods three and the overtime, so it's only going to get worse.
That's exactly right.
Puck is flipped up along the boards into the offensive zone with it as McMahon. She loses it. Kieran Merrill up off the near boards, not out. McMahon dumps it back in deep. Merrill along the end boards. Badger City now skating it out into center ice. Here's Julia Purinton. Purinton across the blue line, 2-on-3. Purinton taking it wide on the backhand, deflected away by Morzik again. And here's Morzik with the puck. Morzik tries to work it out through three white jerseys. She can't. She just keeps moving forward, number 66 in green. Nice stick lift there, and the puck is out. They're looking for that home run pass for Burns again, Eric, and they almost hit her. And that's how they scored their first goal, was on that home run pass to number 2, Joey Burns. And they've missed her on three or four other opportunities, but it's been close.
It definitely has.
Draw now to the right of Reese Doty. Back to the blue line. Worked out here by Tannenberger. Tannenberger to center ice. Back into the zone. Vanessa Hazard. Warhawks into the offensive zone. They throw it cross ice. Down there to play it is Tumpak. She's got both Warhawks goals. Haley Chady now for Badger City. She'll skate up the far side. Nice pass in the middle. It's taken, though, there by Tannenberger. She'll come the other direction, but good defense by Badger City as six players gather right at the blue line. Here's Sitterly across that blue line. Now Sitterly gets double-teamed as she pushes it deep. Sitterly again back to the point. This is Hazard walking in the deflection, and Abby Tumpak is down in front of the net, and that shot actually hit her. Maya Normington tries to play it, but it's swept away by Hazard. Hazard to Burns. Burns mishandles it, but she'll get it back at the blue line. Loses it again. Taken there by Cohen. Riley Cohen, the one-timer, and what a left-pad save by Doty off the stick of Chady. Long outlet pass looking for Balsik, doesn't connect, so that'll be an icing. So Eric, Badger City, after being on their heels for most of this third period, they were that close from turning it around and retaking the lead.
Yeah, really close. We're getting a look at the replay there, and you're right, that was a beautiful, beautiful pad save by Reese Doty.
Haley Chady right in between the circles, and she got all of that one-timer. Lauren Rice will take the draw here against Griffiths. Rice wins it back to the point. Rice has it here, throws it towards the crease, goes through the paint, comes out the other side. Center ice now, Badger City has it. Chipped up ahead, back into the defensive zone for the Warhawks. Badger City will dump it back in as we approach the six-minute mark. Pushed up the near side. Giveaway. Here's a shot by Schwab off the back of the net. McMahon down low. He's able to just dump it out to center ice, and they're going to wave that off. Okay, no icing. Griffiths on the forecheck is able to take the puck there below the red line. She has it on her backhand looking for McMahon on the pass, but it's stolen away. Abby Melota tries the directional self-pass. She gets it, the shot, and she taps home the rebound. And Abby Melota gives her team a 3-2 lead.
Yeah. Nice job by Melota staying with it, Aaron. Getting the first shot attempt, but then staying right around the net.
Yeah, I mean, that started in her in the defensive zone. She worked out to center ice. It was a pretty indirect pass off the boards. She broke in alone on Doty. That first shot, Reese was able to make the save with the left shoulder, but it bounced down right in front of Melota. And you're right, Eric. She stayed with it. She didn't keep skating. She stopped right at the blue paint.
It wasn't a drive-by.
Right. She stopped right at the blue paint, and because she stopped at the blue paint, that rebound was an easy tip-in to give her team the 3-2 lead back with 5 minutes left. Pushed around the far side.
Badger City goal scorer number 19, Abby Melota. Unassisted at 8:33. Badger City goal scored by Melota, unassisted at 8:33.
Down the other way is Morzik across the blue line. She'll take it deep. Morzik in on the backhand and almost tipped in by Burns. Joy just not able to corral that loose puck. Back to the point. D to D. Here's another shot by Morzik. Burns is there. The puck's sitting in the high slot, and it's shoveled into the corner. Burns has it. Back to the point again. Morzik again. Morzik just winds up the slap shot, hits the pads of Nath. Sitterly back to the point again. It's tipped away, and here comes Melota again, has Fulton with her. Melota on the backhand, and it's going to be a penalty called here on the Warhawks as Melota cut across the middle, was tripped by Kennedy. I don't think it's going to be Morzik. I think that's going to be 40-something, 49. That's Bryn Clare going to the box for the trip. But we talk about good penalties sometimes, Eric. I mean, That's a clean two-on-one against someone who just scored a goal to give her another opportunity. But Badger City now with a one-goal lead and a power play.
Yeah, you don't want to be shorthanded here if you're the Warhawks with the time that's remaining.
Warhawks penalty call number 49, Bryn Clare. 2 minutes for tripping at 9:45. Warhawks penalty call number 49, Clare. 2 minutes for tripping at 9:45.
But you're 100% right, Aaron. It's like you, in some of those circumstances, you just don't have a choice.
Tipped up into the air by McMahon. Schwab plays it across the blue line. Over to Sawyer. Sawyer leaves it for Rice. Rice looking for the Hattie. The puck bounces off the end boards, and it's still loose. No whistle yet. Schwab has it in the near corner. Near half board. She's bumped there, knocked down, plays it from her knees, gets it to Rice. Rice below the red line, back to Schwab on the bumper, back to the point. Ballwig, Schwab. Schwab takes the shot and right into the Warhawk in the chest of Reese Doty, who holds on for a whistle. Nice power play, good passing by Badger City here, leads to a screen. But you can kind of see Reese Doty kind of tilting her head to the left, and I feel like she had a pretty good sight line on that shot. Was able to make the easy save. Warhawks out to center ice, and that will be an icing. So time starting to become a factor here for the North Shore Warhawks. We're down to 3 minutes and 16 seconds left in the third period. 3-2. Badger City with the lead. Badger City took a 2-0 lead, a couple of goals by Lauren Rice. And then Abby Tumpak scored two of her own, one in the second, one in the third, to tie it. And then about 2 minutes ago, Addie Melota breaks the tie. Behind the net with it now, Badger City. Up along the near side, the puck is swept away. And here comes Joy Burns trying to use that speed, but good skate work by Kieran Merrill to keep Burns from breaking in. Here's Purinton now. Herrington stops, let the defense go by. It's knocked away. Here comes Burns again. Joey Burns, 2-on-1. Burns leaves it for Sitterly. Sitterly in, and she puts it over the crossbar.
Oh, she's going to have that one in her dreams, nightmares, if the score remains the same.
She had Demarese dead to rights. That puck bounces towards the goal. Sitterly's trying to whack at it. She gets an opportunity, and Demarese makes the left pad save. The bomb from the point comes over to Burns on the near side. Burns back to the point. It's knocked away. A potential 2-on-1 the other direction. Here comes Fulton. Fulton takes the shot. The right pad toe save out to center ice. And that's cleared in for an offsides. Wow, Eric. That was a clean break-in for Joey Burns and Sam Sitterly. And Sam had Demarese down and out. And that's the second time we've seen the Warhawks put the puck over the crossbar like that in a potential scoring opportunity. 2:04 now. Power play is up. Both skated. Both teams 5 to a side. Across the blue line with it. But knocked back out by the Warhawks. Rice is pushed up against the boards by Hunig. Badger City's fine with this, just digging that puck along the boards, killing time down to a minute 39 now. And the Warhawks dig it out this time. They're out to center ice. They gain the red line. And right back the other way. Here's Cohen. Riley Cohen has it on the backhand. Down in the corner with it, just holding the puck. Has it taken away there, though, by Tannenberg. She gets it back. She falls down. We're down to a minute 10. Now Purinton back to the point. Sitterly. Purinton tries to play it from her knees. She can't. It's taken there.
1 minute remaining
of
the period. 1 minute.
Bounces away. Sitterly will give chase, and that will be an icing. A fortunate icing for Badger City as that puck bounced away from Avery Giothanis, and officials could have said that she played the puck, but she didn't, and that'll be an icing. 54 seconds left, and I think we're going to have a timeout called here by the Warhawks.
Yeah, we're absolutely going to get that timeout.
North Shore has taken their timeout.
And obviously, because it's a defensive zone draw, they don't have the opportunity to pull their goalie at this juncture. And if you're Badger City, just keep that puck in the zone. Just keep cycling it around. Just knock the time off the clock.
Right, every second that you can keep that puck stuck up against the end boards or in the corner or something like that, you know, it's kind of what you're going to see from Badger City here more than likely. Either if you can get the puck into the corner and just dig it there, go ahead, or if you can turn around and get it out and clear it out of the zone, go ahead and do that too.
Yeah.
So we've had yet another good game here. It's usually what happens when the best of the best get together. You don't see a lot of running clock in the third periods in many of these games.
Yeah, I mean, our first game, the 10U game, that was
4-1.
The Ice Dogs juggernaut,
yeah.
You know. But that was close for a little bit there, too.
That was 2-1 into the third. That Ice Dogs team, one of the top 10U teams, not only in the state but in the country. They went undefeated. I want to say they were 17-0-1 this season or something ridiculous like that. One of the highest scoring 10U teams in the country. So, I mean, that juggernaut is the right word for them. But even that game wasn't a blowout as Mammoth stuck with them. You said it yourself, a couple of goals in that third period for the Ice Dogs put that one away. But, yeah, we've seen three good games so far. Hopefully three more good ones on the agenda. So this draw is going to come to the right of Reese Doty. 54.9 left to go in the third.
This is a huge draw for the Warhawks.
Yep, to be taken by Abby Tumpak. She wins it. Morzik tries to push it up the far boards and can't. And this is what I was talking about. Badger City's totally fine with that. Cleared in deep. Here's Morzik. Or excuse me, that's Tumpak. Tries the self-pass, but four white jerseys back, and they do a nice job fending Tumpak off. Cross ice, here is Tumpak now with 30. She'll dump in chase.
There goes the goalie.
Down there with Sitterly, the goalie to the box. Tumpak in the corner now. pushed over to the near boards. Stolen away by McMahon. McMahon behind the net. The forehand, the shot, and the save is made by Demarese. There was their opportunity. We're down to 10. McMahon has to hurry down to 7. McMahon through center ice has the puck stolen away by Addy Melota. Melota with the exclamation point with 0.9 seconds left. And Badger City is going to win the girls 16U, 19U national champion. They had a chance there, Eric.
They did.
Warhawks had an opportunity right in front of the net, and once again, Jesse Demarese comes up huge, and Addy Melota picks up her second goal of the game, the empty netter, with 0.9 seconds left. Drop the puck, and we'll watch Badger City celebrate.
Badger City goal, her second of the game, score by number 19, Addy Melota. Unassisted at 19:59.
Yeah, there it was quite is. A performance by Badger City, Aaron. Yep. But the Warhawks gave them everything they can handle, and as you said, down to the wire.
Yep.
They had a shot.
Yep. On that last rush, Eric, they had an opportunity right out front, and Sam Sitterly. Yeah, you talk about that play about with about 2 or 3 minutes left. Sam Sitterly. It's probably going to be thinking about that one on the way home today. She was all alone in front of Jesse Demarese and just put the backhand up over the net, and Badger City holds on for the 4-2 victory. So once we're done with the handshake, which I still believe is the greatest tradition in sports, the handshake hockey line after a playoff game, we will announce, or not we will announce, but they will announce the three stars of the game. But another good game, another fun game, another good outcome depending on who you're rooting for, I guess. But Badger City emerges victorious 4-2. Lauren Rice, 2 goals. Addy Melota, 2 goals. I'm curious who they're going to give the 3 stars to. We had 6 goals in the game scored by 3 players. So you have to think maybe Abby Tumpak, Lauren Rice, and Addy Melota?
Yeah, I think Tumpak's definitely going to get a star, even though she's from the losing team. I mean, she was the reason why they were in that game.
Yep. Yep.
Yeah.
I mean, you could easily go with either goalie as well. Both Reese Doty and Jesse Demarese played outstanding for both teams. Demarese made some unbelievable saves in this game as the Warhawks really gave her everything she could handle.
There you see Hannah Chady.
She put her helmet on.
Yeah. I love it.
So congratulations to the Badger City girls. They are the Nye-Hill Blackhawks 16U, 19U national champions. We've got our 3 stars down there trying to make out the numbers. I see Tumpak. I believe that's Addy Melota. And in the middle, is that Rice, number 6?
Probably. I don't see any goalie pads. So.
No goalie pads. I believe that's number 6.
Now it's time to announce the 3 stars of the game. From the North Shore Warhawks with 2 goals, number 10, Abby Tumpak. From Badger City with 2 goals, number 6, Lauren Rice. And from Badger City with 2 goals, number 19, Addy Melota. Please turn your attention to the ice where John Hansen and Jenna Rose are with the 3 stars.
Thank you very much, Gene Hanna here with Abby scoring 2 goals. Obviously not the result you wanted, but a tough fought game, huh?
Yep.
Let's make some noise here for Abby. We got an award there as well. Congratulations, one of the 3 stars of the game. Jenna, over to you.
All right, we're joined by Lauren. Congratulations, scored twice in this one. Got your team on the board first. Why was that so important to change the momentum?
Just to have like the excitement of the goal gets the whole team going.
Yeah, it certainly does. Well, congratulations. This is very well deserved. Let's make some noise, everybody. All right, moving over this way. You had 2 as well on the evening, but what does it mean to you to win on this ice with your friends?
It's my last game with them in the Nye-Hill League, so just going out strong and having fun.
Well, you certainly did. Congratulations. Very well deserved. Let's make some noise for all of our competitors here today.
So there you have it, your 3 stars of the game. Abby Tumpak from the Warhawks. She had a couple of goals. Lauren Rice, as Jenna said, got Badger City on the board early with 2 goals, giving them a 2-0 lead. And then Addy Melota goals 3 and 4 to finish things off for Badger City. They win the 16U-19U Girls National Champions. So Eric and I are going to step aside here. We're going to hang out here, though, for a couple of minutes. We're going to let the video take us away. We're going to get some video of the teams picking up their flags, taking the lap around with the trophy. But Eric and I are going to step away here. We'll be back with the 14U Bantam Premier Select Championship here in a little bit. Hope you enjoyed this broadcast, and we'll talk to you soon.
Will the representative from Badger City please come forward to receive your banner? Congratulations to Badger City.